Beer babes, this is Will. Just jumping on at the start of this to let you know that this is some of the B-roll, you know, and some of the stuff that didn't quite fit in our initial episode where we talked to Andrew from Communion. It was such a great day. We had an awesome time. So this one's pretty silly. Some of us driving down, and then a few of the outtakes and setup, and actually a real cool sort of sneak peek behind and get a more in-depth look at the brewery itself. But it didn't quite fit in the other episode, so but I'd put it all together and chuck it here so you can check it out. So make sure you watch and enjoy.
Are we allowed to record people's number plates?
No. You can film whatever you want. I'm editing, so I just won't put any of it in.
I can't see the dirt pile. There we go. Focus, baby. Can I zoom while recording? Yes, I can. So steady. My hand's so steady.
Whatnot, so and then seating out here, so you've got big tables up against the window there, so there's a wall open right out, which would be obviously pretty cool.
Yeah, it'll be sick,
especially in the summer, it'd be great.
Yeah,
they've got their big Chesterfield lounges around the corner there. Big
like old school, kind of dark and kind of, yep.
And then the booths, and then we've got out the side there, there's a car park, and we'll have beer going out there. So the two spaces won't be linked. That's the only bad thing about the design. Okay. But that'll have its own bar out there, and
yep.
We'll be able to run food down there. That's fine.
So you kind of walk out the street, walk to the beer garden kind of thing.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. Yeah, it's not too bad. Summer's coming up, so
exactly. I know.
Yeah.
Oh man, I'm so.
Do you know what was this place before?
Well, directly before it was like a Xerox shop, which is pretty boring.
Yeah. Printers and
yeah. Fireplace, which is also pretty boring.
Okay, cool.
But before that, it was one of the coast's biggest car dealerships. So Smith & Dunn, you can still see some of the lettering on the outside of the building.
Okay.
And I think, you know, we've got receipts from cars that were purchased for, you know, £100 or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so it was kind of cool. But after that, it was a bit boring.
Yeah.
Quite a couple of years in time.
Yep. You could put a bit of history up in the wall.
Yeah, I know.
At least I'll add a cool part of
the
history.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. That's it. You can be the cool history.
So we'll have a direct draw for the beer serving, so just straight into the back of the brewery here, the bar will be, which is on the other side there.
Cool.
Two beer on the and then the brewery.
Yeah.
So you've got 500 litre brew house.
Make sure you got this bill.
I got it.
This is the brew house, 500 litres with an oversized HLT. So we can do double batching. So we can run a second batch through before the first one's finished. So halfway through the watering process, we'll match in again and chase it through. It's like hectic as.
Yeah, I reckon.
But it's a boutique system, so it's an Australian company.
Yep.
Built by NDL in China.
Okay.
But I deal with boutique, the guys, yes. And Alan and Gavin Croxler, absolute legends in the beer industry in Australia. So they help me design it all, and spec it, and then came down and installed it and got it all running. Neil then came down and did the first couple of brews on it to get it up and running, and then that's into my home devices. So
yeah, pretty cool.
So then so we've got it's all a double size system, so 500 liter greenhouse, which is just probably normally you'd go 1,000.
Yep.
But trying to bring the most out of this side thing possible, and we've got 1,000 liter body tanks, fermenters up there. So the 6,000 liter fermenters, so we've just canned yesterday, so 6,800 cans, and then the rest of the kegs. So there's one tank that's still full, which it's good beer, it just wasn't the right beer.
It wasn't what you're out.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
So nothing didn't work.
Yep.
Yeah. Cool.
So what do we do? I've got
one person here.
Yep, and then...
One person here.
Yep, and then...
One person here.
Yeah, that's perfect.
Yeah.
It's really good.
Cool.
So this is the good stuff.
As fresh as it gets.
And you had them mixed up with your boxes?
Yeah, I had ordered some IBA branded ones to come, and they just were about a week late.
Yeah.
So yeah, I was like, Stew! I need some unbranded boxes. The cans that didn't come off didn't get a label.
Okay.
So it's if you want a mystery,
yeah,
then you can have a dig in there.
Yep.
Or one of 6,800 actual cans. So we've got,
hey, boys.
You guys need to come and
boys, come
can.
Pick a can. This would be a good shot.
So we've got Dusty, local expert, which is the pale ale, we'll pick that next time. We've got the paper maker, which is our lager. We've got the Dusty Wanderer, which is the XPA, Old Mate, Coffee Porter, so that's the one with 170 double espressos from the chapel. Eight litres of cold brew in a tank. And then we've got the Clock Watcher, which is the Session IPA. Five in tins.
Ours?
Mm. One local expert. That's yours.
Beautiful.
And we go the lager.
You
want
to mystery box?
I'll go the
session.
Nice.
You grab it, Dick.
Oh.
So.
I don't think
cross this new divide. Can you turn the clock watcher a bit?
This one?
With the numbers at the top now.
These numbers?
Up the top. See how they got that full label?
That's a session IPA.
Oh, one, two.
I can get them both.
So we need to figure out how we're going to do this, boys. You need a table or something?